ಗೋಡೆ ವಾಸನೆ ಈ ಕಡೆ ಬಾಕಿದೆ.
Good morning, friends.
Good morning, sir.
Make some noise.
Good morning, sir.
Good morning, sir.
Good morning, sir.
Morning, sir.
Good morning, sir.
Good morning, sir.
Prepare adra fully. Fully prepare adra andro. Tuition class fully odi aita. Are you able to hear anything?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Let us have some music in life. Okay. Share screen. Is it visible? Something is visible there?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
E asirusiriyali manasu mereyali navile.
Those who can understand Kannada.
ಮನಸ್ಸು ಮೆರೆಯಲಿ ನವಿಲೆ ನಿನ್ನಂಗೆ ಕುಣಿವೆ ನಿನ್ನಂತೆಯೇ ನಲಿವೆ
ಯುವರ್ ಏಬಲ್ ಟು ಸೀ ದಿ ಬಜೆಟ್
ಯೆಸ್ ಸರ್
The song was those who are new, unknown to Kannada. It is talking about a peacock, and by hearing that song about a peacock, you would have seen what happened to the peacock, isn't it? So let's quickly go through the other important amendments. Welcome back. We went through up to section. Muakta jela Niranjan.
Yes, sir. Atte.
So. The other amendments beyond 100, 115A. So obviously, since 115O is removed, what is 115O?
Dividend.
115O is talking about dividend. I told yesterday also, dividend-related provisions have been withdrawn from 14/2020. So since dividend-related provisions are withdrawn. So everywhere, wherever there is a dividend reference, they have removed that. So 115O is talking about DDT. They removed it just for understanding purpose. Then under 115A, the special rate of taxation. Okay, the rate of tax has been made as 5%. So from budget 2020, may not be so important. 115BD again incidental amendment. What is 115BD? 115BBD is about investment in foreign company. But 115BBDA, in 115BBDA?
1 lakh limit for dividend. 10 lakh.
Work. My video off, Iriya. Iga, now it's on. Okay.
Yes, sir.
See, okay. Dividend taxation. I'll just summarize repeatedly. Till 2020, 31st March 2020, every domestic company had to pay dividend distribution tax at 15%. With grossing up, it used to come to 20.56%. whereas 222E dividend was taxed taxed at 30% without grossing up till 31st March 2020. So till 31st March 2020, that means company had to pay the normal corporate tax. What are the profit, the distribution tax, dividend distribution tax they had to pay. In addition, that when the shareholder is receiving, if it is taxable, meaningless. That's why 1034 was giving an exemption. But they said, no, no, there are some very rich people, they are earning in crores, so let's slightly tax them. So they say up to 10 lakh rupees, if you are received in aggregate dividend, it is exempted under 1034. If you receive anything above 10 lakh rupees, on that excess, you are supposed to pay 10% tax in the head of shareholder. So till 31st March 2020, company had to pay normal corporate tax. Then dividend distribution tax, they are supposed to pay around 20%. And if it is above 10 lakh rupees, shareholder has to pay again, has to pay tax of 10%. So there's a triple taxation, not double taxation, triple taxation on the same income. So since from 1/4 2020, there's a substantial amendment saying that dividend, there is no dividend distribution tax. That means all incidental amendment will come into picture. You know, so dividend, company has to pay the normal tax, full stop, that's it. The company doesn't have to pay DDT. That means who has to pay the tax? Shareholder. In the normal case, 56-1, it is income from other source. A tax as a normal income. For example, Surabhi the student receives 2 lakh dividend. No other income, zero tax. The Niranjan, the employee, receives 2 lakh dividend. His other income is already 20 lakh. 2 lakh gets taxed at 30%. So no confusion at all. Confusion. So as of now, 2020-21, I'm talking about. Share company, no dividend distribution tax. Shareholder, it is going to be taxed as a normal income. No exemption. This one. 151BD LRC, that also has been removed. So this date, don't be confused. Be careful. That's a green. It is inapplicable from 1/4 2020. They have made a reference to section 12AB, which was supposed to be introduced from 1/6 2020, which I told you has been deferred from 1/6 2020 to 1/4 2021. Am I too fast?
No, sir.
Our new friends are able to accept, I hope. Hopefully. Yeah. Then wherever there's a reference, they have made reference. Okay. 115JC, it is talking about AMT. 115JB is about minimum alternative tax. 115JC is about alternative minimum tax other than corporates. So the due date again, 44AB due date has been mentioned. Instead of due date, they are going to make it a what? Specified date. The word used is what? Specified date. And this section is not applicable if FSC has exercised 115BAC, individual HF, which comes a little later. Okay. Or 115BAD. What is 115BAD?
For the corporates.
22%. And similar provision has been introduced under 115JD. 115JD is about AMT credit for next 15 years. Okay. Same. Repeated provision. 115TD talks about accredited income. If time permits, today only I'll solve that and tell you. And they have just added some words of 12A and 12AB. 115BAC is very, very important. Extremely important. Compulsory question. So my new friends, okay. 115BAC is an option given from previous year 21-22. Whenever you're learning the law, learn in previous year. But when you're writing, you just add 1 year and write assessment year. If you are an individual or HF, resident, non-resident, 65 years, 95 years, madamagaya, you are given an option to go by the normal tax rate, which was applicable in earlier years also. That is up to 2.5 lakh, nearly 2.5 lakh to 5 lakh, 5%, 5 lakh to 10 lakh, 20%, about 10 lakh, 30%. Or you can go by this scheme. What is starting with the same 2.5 lakh. So every 2.5 lakh increase, simple, you don't have to buy hard this. There's a tax rate increase of 5% and stops at 30%. So that means that higher slab of 10 lakh has now become, it will push to 50 lakh. Wow, excellent, extraordinary, wow, the tax rates are less. So in the class only I approved it in the recent, maybe 1 week back for the present batch students, where in most of the cases, new option what is given is not beneficial. In most of the cases, one or two cases, it will be there. So you have to go by case-to-case basis, case-to-case basis. So if you are a PGBP SSE, you have to apply this option within 139.1 due date. 139.1 due date. Once you exercise, it is applicable forever. Once you default any of the conditions, you will never be able to enter into this. You will never be able to enter into this 115BAC. Whereas if you do not have PGBP income, so you can exercise anytime before 139, full stop. I didn't say 139.1. So before 139, that means belated return, what do you call it, revised return, whatever. So as long as you're filing return under 139 and not in pursuance of notice under section 142.1, okay, you can still operate. And year on year basis, you can keep on changing it. So obviously the software, etc. will be developed in such a way that, okay, where individual of having PGBP income, full stop. Last year you applied, you automatically come under this. Unless, what do you call it? And once you come out of this, you cannot, what do you call, get inside. All other SSEs, okay, other than PGBP, they can choose this every time when they file their return, even if it's a billet return, absolutely fine. Next, 133A, the procedure related to survey has been slightly amended. If the intimation is received, you have to take the prior approval of joint director or joint commissioner. In all the cases, the prior approval of director or commissioner itself is required. Commission is required. This amendment number, etc. of the clauses of, I'm sorry, budget. Next, 139.1, earlier, so myself and Surabhi are partners in a partnership firm having a tax audit. I am a working partner. For me, the due date is same as partnership firm. So she is a sleeping partner. For her, the due date is not same. It would have been 31 July. Now they say, once you are a partner in the tax audit firm, whether you are working partner or sleeping partner, due date is the same as that of the firm. Agreed? Right. Next, 140, signing of returns. Who can sign the returns? So earlier it used to be director only by company. LLP case only partners. So now they said any other person prescribed as per the rules. You have to go and see the prescribed definition is also there in section 2. If you go and see as per the rules, okay, what is prescribed there accordingly, you have to see. Then grammatical corrections, leave it. I don't get into that. Okay. 191.2, one big amendment. Okay. So if you are a ATIAC eligible setup, all of you are able to understand, can you just give a reaction once? If it is fast, slow, whatever it may be, reaction. Reaction, please, all of you, including my new friends. Ithar, yaadho thikki reaction kodi, paravagila. Ithar reaction kodi, paravagila. I am loving DT anta. I am in love anta, Allah. Okay, all of you are able to understand? Kellar rode on malkund malkund bittavare, papa, as usual. Anybody find it tough, fast, nothing? Okay, nothing is happening. Okay, so Kuldeep says nothing is happening at the world like else. Okay, no problem. Let's go ahead. You know, right. So, to ensure that your time should not be wasted, yesterday night full kutkon mitella color maadkon ready itkondi ini ivattu. I didn't even otherwise normally coloring ella class la maadidde ivattu ella adanne maadibidini sumne. Your time is important. So, if you are eligible set up under a ETIAC, are you listening? ETIAC, fine. Then only for you, there is an amendment. For all other SSE, look at this yellow color, no change in the law, no change. So if you are eligible SSE, then perquisite. So ESOP has been given to you. Let's say 30 lakh is the ESOP. They say ESOP is taxable in the year in it is exercised where the option is granted. Rubbish, I may be selling this after 3 years because of the vesting period, lock-in period, etc. Where will I pay the tax? How will I pay the tax? Law understood. Okay, you are a startup company, ETIAC, then I will give you relaxed time limit. It has to be paid within 14 days from what? From the expiry of 48 months from the end of the relevant assessment year. So it is, you'll get minimum 5 years. Previous year plus 1 year is called assessment year. From there you get to 4 years. So 48 months. That means you get, and so if you exercise on, let's say April or September or March, okay, let the previous year end. Let the assessment year end. From there, you get to 4 more years. After 4 years, 14 days. That means effectively 14th April of 1 year. Understanding? Or from the date of actual sale. Suppose if you have sold it within 48 months, actual sale. Or from the date SSE ceasing to be an employee. If you quit that employment, whichever is earlier. So that 14 days from any of these three important events, it is applicable. With beautiful examples are there. So Ravi, special color company or Malcolm Mittalle. Yeah. So, with the examples, just you can glance through the example early. Or one of the very dedicated student of CAPS, for non-ATAC, no change in the law. What are the original law? Same law will continue. 143 talks about assessment. 143, I love you, Nagate, I hate you, Nagate. 143 and Reno assessment. So, in the case of assessment, they have brought some slight changes as far as the procedural aspect. So, the direction period has been extended, which is initially up to 31st March 2020. So, now they give an extension up to 31st March 2022. Next, 144C, DRP, Dispute Resolution Panel. Okay, so income or loss return, earlier the word was there. That means, earlier you could have gone to DRP only with income or loss return. Now you can go for any matter for DRP, as may be prescribed. Fine. So resident, non-resident, everybody is included. Small, small. Incidental correction, fine. 181.2 I discussed now. Yeah. Just a minute. Yeah. Dividend. 194 was almost a defunct section. 194 was talking about dividend TDS, Niranjan. So dividend was exempted. Why TDS? Now they said they brought back. It's got a life like ATM yesterday, I said. So 184 has also has been brought back. 10% TDS has been made. Any mode, you give the dividend by any mode. Actually, dividend has to be paid by only by other than cash as per the Companies Act, section 123. Okay, but here is a any mode you give, and I don't care. You need to do the TDS if you are paid more than 5,000 rupees. More than 5,000. 184A, I'm sorry, 184A. And most of the sections down. Listen carefully. Big amendment. One more big amendment. What used to happen earlier is, so TDS obligations are applicable to all the payers of income. Correct word, payers of income, other than individual HEF, full stop. So I am a company, no question asked. There is a TDS. I am subject to conditions of TDS. For example, company pays 25,000 professional fees, no TDS. Because 184J says it should have been 30,000. Are you understanding? So a company pays 32,000 rupees. Last year, company just started. TDS is applicable here. That's it. Close. Whereas individual HEF, small, chota mota fellas, don't bother. Don't tell them to pay the taxes. Anagayu bhagat. Okay. So what they did now, earlier the law was, if you are a 44AB, what is 44AB? Most important section for a chartered accountant. Tax related case. There are five clauses there. 44AB, small a, small b, small c, small d, small e. The old law was, if you are an SSC covered under 44AB A or B, then this year you should go for a TDS. Just to give an example, last year, so Shetty Sir Parmida, I am the proprietor, my turnover was, let us say, 240 lakh. I was coming under 44AB clause A. This year, from day one, I should do the TDS. So based on the immediately preceding previous year turnover. So based on 44AB clause A. Now they say, 44AB is confusing. So many things are there. So they said, let us not get into that. 44AB, all of you listening, 44AB, A's, E, etc. Don't get into that. If you are an SSC having turnover more than 100 lakh in the last year, or professional case, if it is more than 50 lakh, this year you should do the TDS. That's it. Okay. So there is no mention about 44AB clause, AB, etc. Are you clear about it? And this amendment is there in most of the resident related sections, 184A, 184C, 184J, all kind of same. I'm not going to repeat this. Have you understood this point, Baba? So no confusion about. So because 44AB again has got 5 crore tax solid limit. Last year, so be careful, especially when you're giving a consultancy to the client. Last year, if you are a tax solid case, this year you should do the TDS. That's a statement we used to make. I'm sorry. Last year, if it is above 100 lakh, you should do it. And what is the turnover? I'm worried. Sales is 90 lakh plus GST is 18 lakh. Let us assume easy hypothetically. 108 lakh. Sir, I am following exclusive method of accounting. 90 lakh is my turnover. I am worried your turnover is 108 lakh. 108 lakh. Because 145A says turnover should be inclusive of indirect taxes. That's how you are supposed to include purchase, sales, and inventory. Going well? Understanding well? Yeah, fine. There is one interesting senior citizen definition has been omitted. Senior citizen. That 184A, 50,000 limit is still omitted. Why? Because, okay, it has been defined in some other sections in the simple way. They said there's no necessity to have a definition here. Let us not waste our time. Okay. And some date notification. So, one more big amendment. Society, corporate society. I'm not talking about cooperative banks. Many of us will get confused with cooperative bank. Classified as trust. National cooperative bank compulsory has to do the TDS. Whereas National Cooperative Society, when they are paying the interest, they were not liable to do the TDS. Earlier, societies never, there was no income tax at all. 224 within the bracket 7A has been introduced, okay, saying that income of these societies are also going to be taxable. So I'm not talking about banks, I'm talking about society. National Cooperative Society is different from National Cooperative Bank. So if that society, so there are no income in the way, there's where the question of doing that. TDS. Now they say, no. If you're a big society, you do the TDS. Who is bigger? Turnover or gross in the last year, 50 crores, 5,000 lakhs. My suggestion to all my friends, learn in lakhs so that you don't have confusion. Anyway, this is a amendment budget, so I didn't want to change that wording, sir. 50 crores or the 5,000 lakhs during the preceding financial year, last year, and interest paid is more than 40,000 or 50,000 as the case may be. Normal cases, 40,000 senior citizens above 50,000 rupees. You need to do the TDS. Artha ita. Next 184 C, they have added one extra word called associate. See, look at this. All the sections I said 1 crore 50 lakh, 1 crore 50 lakh. Almost all kada change agide. Artha ita. 184 J, one big amendment and big observation by us in this current class. Thanks to Niranjan. 184 J talks about 5 major items: professional fees, fees for technical service, then any remuneration to director other than covered under 192, then non-competing fees, one more, you know, royalty. Right. So all these cases, okay, all these cases, okay. So we used to say 30,000 limit for all of them, Anta. But then recently when we observed, okay, 30,000 is applicable only for, this is not a budget amendment. I'm talking about the existing law. 30,000 applicable to all the four cases. So not applicable to one case. Which is that one case? Present batch 20.
Director's
remuneration. You have paid 1 rupee, there's a TDS. We have to be careful, extremely careful. So look at this. I'm a company, because direct remuneration question comes into picture only if you're a company. Otherwise, it's not applicable. So I am a company. Surabhi is a director. She is an employee. Full stop. No discussion here, because it comes under 182. 182 is an important section related to salary. That's it. Full stop. She is non-employee director. We have paid her 10,000 rupees. TDS has to be done. Whereas if you have paid her professional fees 30,000 plus royalty 30,000, non-competing fees 30,000 rupees. In all those cases, there is no TDS at all. Only if it is a director's remuneration, if you have paid 1 rupee also, which is not covered under 192, any payment to director, it comes as a TDS, first observation. That is not a budget amendment, it is an earlier amendment. Even we used to say all the five, but when we closely observed it, what, that's what we understood. Point number one. Point number two, if you're an individual HF, again, 1 crore, the 100 lakh and 50 lakh cases, that is applicable to you. If you are an individual HF, you need to do the TDS only for, that means, you as a payer only for professional fees and fees for technical service. Okay, for other things you don't have to do any TDS, because direct remuneration question will not come, because in a proprietorship who is a director, film director, is not applicable. Then there is a rate change. Normally TDS is 10% under 184J. However, now I think 2 budget back they have changed 2%. This budget again they have added one more item. If it is a fees for technical service not being a professional fees, or royalty in relation to cinematography films, it is going to be 2%. In all the cases, 10%. So, FTS, not in the nature of professional fees, or royalty which is related to cinematography films, any other royalty, it is going to be 10% only. This is a very important specific amendment. You have to take care of it. All of you able to understand, Baba?
Yes.
Yes, sir.
I have given the beautiful 2% for pay being engaged in business of call center. This, all, this is an amendment of 2017, not this year. 2%. 2% for FTS or royalty related to cinematograph films. In all other cases, 10%. Professional fees is always going to be 10%. Can I continue? Fine. So 184K time pass. 184LBA is about the business trust. 5% or 10%, etc. Just glance it. Fine. Amendment, import, all this are related to business trust. Okay. 184LC or LB, all this are related to business trust. Just glance it. Fine. So very rarely asked section, let us not waste. This one, big, big, big amendment. 184N. Okay, now all these people are listening to my class. You should be writing the exam in May 21 and onwards. January 21, these amendments are not applicable. Okay, those are writing in the cycle 2. Okay, so January 21, these amendments are not applicable, because for you, I think previous year is 1920 itself, if I'm not wrong. I'm sure that's the right answer. Anyway, no need. Next, TDS on payment in cash. So, 184N, Nanna Kasu, in almost all South Indian language, Nanna means mine. So 184N, N for mine. Okay. So if I withdraw money, so the person is paying, who is paying? The banker mainly, or the post office, they need to do the TDS. This law was originally introduced in 2019 budget with effect from 1st September 2019. And there the law was, if you pay above 100 lakh, only on the excess you are supposed to do that. Whereas 2020 budget has replaced the 184N with a new 184N with effect from 1st July 2020. That means 1st September 2019, these dates are very crucial after MCQ being introduced. 1st September 2019 to 30th June 2020, you still have to go by the old law. Whereas after 1st July 2020, you have to go by the new law, which say, like in the normal cases, you need to do the TDS on the entire amount. Like normal TDS law, you know, I pay 29,000 rupees professional fees to Niranjan. No TDS. I pay 31,000. TDS is on 1,000 or 31,000?
31,000.
Whereas 184N, last year they said, if you have paid 120 lakh, it is only on 20 lakh. From now, 1st July 2020, they say, if you have paid 120 lakh on entire 120 lakh. This is exactly what it is. So, TDS rates are normally when from one or more, X is 100 lakh. So, this example you go through, right? 120 lakh paid in 1920, TDS is 2% on 20 lakh. Paid after 1st July 2020, 2% on entire 120 lakh. Are you there? There is one more big amendment. Okay. So, you being a person who is withdrawing more than 100 lakh cash from a current account, okay, and you are not filing the ITR, just looks, sounds at least illogical in most of the cases. One or two special cases, you are a senior citizen, you have deposited money, and you are withdrawing now after retirement. That's okay. But otherwise, how can you have a no income? You are not filing the return. In the last 3 years, if you are not filing the return at all, then they say the TDS rate for the bank to do it is up to 20 lakh, don't bother. 20 lakh to 100 lakh, you have to do 2%. And above 100 lakh, you have to do 5%, not 2%. This is a big, big amendment. Understanding? Yeah. Okay. Then 184O, one more big section, which is introduced, newly introduced. TDS by e-commerce operator, Amazon, Appejon, Flipkart, etc. So these people, when they make payments to the persons who are using their platform, they need to do the TDS at 1% of the gross sales or services as the case may be. So probably I think this example will make you understand better. Let's say Max Showroom sells textiles to Dhanush and Archana through Amazon. Amazon is called e-commerce operator. So Max is called e-commerce participant. Dhanush and Archana are the customers. So when the customer pay directly to Max or through Amazon on the total amount, there should be a TDS. There's a beautiful example which you can go through it. Are you there? Okay. And not applicable, especially if you are making a payment to an individual HF, small players in the market, if they're there, if it's less than 5 lakh rupees amount involved. Fine. The lending culture is about the hosting of arrangement, etc. Come into picture. So fine. So in examples, Amazon deducting TDS, etc. So if there's a commission payment, it comes under 184H normal cases. Only for the gross sale payment, etc., it comes under 184O. Right. Then dividend related provisions. These are all small special provisions. You can glance it. 206AA. Normally, if you don't give the PAN, the tax rate is, TDS rate is as high as 20%. However, if you are a 184O case, what is the TDS rate I told you to do it? 184O.
1%
to 20% is too illogical. For 184O, they said maximum rate is 5% instead of 20%. Similar provision amendment has happened in 206CC, which is talking about TCS. So TCS, there's again, big amendment. Again, 100% question definite. MCQ nalli, what's kothira? Take extra care. Now, record akta idella, everything is happening, Alva?
Yes, sir. Okay.
Okay, well, fine, yeah. Now, authorized dealer. So there are three major items which have been added. 206, 1G. 1G is a new insertion now. Okay. If an authorized dealer, the money changers, the Thomas Cook, for remittance out of India, so they need to do that. But this is again, special point, I have made it red. Not a normal project. This is how you should learn. So normally, if I pay 7 lakh, you should do the TDS on entire amount. Illi they say, so when amount is greater than 7 lakh, 5% TCS on exceeding 7 lakh. So it is something like a last year's to 194N. Understanding? Example, amount received is 9 lakh. TCS is 5% only on 2 lakh. So 7 lakh is the limit. And a special case, if it is a loan remittance, loan doesn't have income as such, but still they say small 0.5% TDS you do. If it is a loan referred under ATEE for educational loan. Understanding? Next. If you are the seller of OTP, what is OTP? One-time password, huh? Overseas tour package program, okay, there without any monetary ceiling, you need to do a TDS at 5%. So, TCS. So, here the TCS is 5%, here also 5%. Here TCS is on excess amount, So 0.5%, 0.5% only for loan amount, whereas OTP without any limit, no 7 lakh as a limit, then you have to do 5%. TCS, sorry. Yeah. Next. That's fine. 2061H, one big amendment again. So for all the sellers of goods, all the sellers, so that means Pan Beda businessman used to do it. No. So every seller of goods, comma, whose turnover in the immediately preceding financial year exceeded 10 crores, 1000 lakhs, 10 crores. See, three different turnover limit. Now only I discuss. Normal 44 AB limit, they have made it 100 lakh or 50 lakh. So somewhere else, actually, I mentioned about 194 owner listed, then no turnover limit 50 crores, like a net worth under Ind AS. Ind AS, if you go and see, that is a wording separate. So the wordings, not amount, only 500 crores is there. Then here 10 crores immediately preceding the financial year. So if you're a seller of goods, you need to do the TCS provided to that person concerned, the limit is 50 lakh. Let me explain this. My turnover, okay, last year is, let us say, 12 crores. I come inside this. Then the sales what I made to Prajna Shetty is 40 lakh, no TCS. I made sales to Anaga 60 lakh. There's a TCS at 0.1%, small 0.1%, because normally purchase and sale should not attract TDS or TCS. But still they say, because huge amount you have sold, that's why you should do the TCS. Arthakta idea? Fair enough. Fine. So, and when the PAN or Aadhaar is not submitted, okay. So there I said, no, 184 only. So maximum rate is 5%. Here, there's a twice the rate on Chittu. Okay. Here, normally 2016 only, when you don't give the, I repeat this, sorry, 2 RMRs. In TDS case, if PAN is not submitted, the maximum rate was normally 20%. But for 184 case, it has been capped at 5%. Understood? TCS only, maximum rate is normally, because the TCS rates are only 1%, 2%, you know, maximum rate was actually 5%. Twice the rate or what is 5%. But in the case of 1H year, 0.1% TCS you're asking, how can you go up to 5%? That's a maximum is 1% cap. Understood? Yeah. Then PM CARES. So some of you may not be knowing the full form. Many of you may not know that there's a full form. PM CARES, Andre, there's a full form. It is the Prime Minister, Narendra Modi, cares about me, Allah. Okay. So no doubt he cares. Citizen Assistance and Relief in the Emergency Situation Fund. That's the full form of CARES. And there's a big, big announcement. 13th of January, they are going to, what do you call, give the vaccination in India. That's what they say. Okay. So there are two, I think, vaccines have been approved by the government of India. Hopefully, by God's grace, everything goes well. Okay. Let us wait and watch. Not for you and me, for the frontliners. Okay. Or quickly, they are absolutely right in their decision. Right. Coming back. So, this is one amendment related to the trust, etc., which we discussed in the last class. So all these amendments I summarized, rather Surabhi, in this table form. So this, the whatever some provisions related to 1023C, 12AB, all these have been summarized in the form. It basically says from 1/4/2021, you know, special color model. So, from 1/4/2021, all the institution funded set registered at 12A, 12AB or 1023C. Just to give an example, CAPS Foundation, or CAPS Foundation T-shirt accompanying. So, CAPS Foundation is a charitable trust, CAPS Allah, CAPS Foundation is a charitable trust coming under 12A, 12AA and 12AB new section. 1023C is mainly for all these government related schemes. PM CARES Fund, Swachh Bharat Kosh, Prime Minister's Relief Fund, all those funds, they come under 1023C. Some medical institutions, the universities, etc. also, they come. The objective is similar, but the procedural aspects are different. For both, there is a similar amendment which has happened, which says, from 1st April 2021 onwards, so you need to give a fresh application for registration. Normally, the 3 months time will be given, and normally, that application given will be approved within 3 months. And from there, you will get 5 years validity so that once you are approved, first next 5 years you can relax. That means after 5 years, again, you need to do the reapply. But not, you should not wait for 5 years. You should do effectively before 4.5 years get over. That's the gist of this amendment. Are you understanding? So within 3 months, normally you need to apply for it. The department will approve normally within 3 months from the end of the month of the application. And once it is approved, it is valid for next 5 years. So before the 4.5 years, that the wording is somewhere it comes down. 6 months prior to the end of the approval, you need to apply. That means 5 years validity given. I'm sure you're reasonably understanding. It is a revision class, I'm telling you, my dear friend. If you're not attended the regular class, if you don't understand, I don't think I'm wrong. Okay. So those who attended, you are able to understand?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
So others also at least go through once, probably you'll be able to catch it. Okay. So 6 months prior, okay, you need to do the application, especially in that case. So this is the sum and substance of the entire. And go to that table one to one. I told you the regular class to write that. Okay. All are related to that. This is what I was telling. 12A, okay. 12AB, which is supposed to be from 1-6-2020, which has been deferred to 1-4-2021. This gist of this has been given in this above table. Big, big amendment. 12AB is a new section for a registration. So, okay. Now, sir, if I don't do, what happens? Don't worry. ADG 1023C or section 35, if you don't do all those, you're supposed to submit some statements also. If you don't do that, like 234E, now there's a fees, not penalty, which is compulsory, 200 rupees per day, 200 per day, which is a very, very dangerous. Fine. Then there are some procedural amendments. So procedure to appeal. Now they're going for faceless assessment. Now we are going for faceless appeal. Okay. So where you can appeal. One of the beautifully drafted thinking, whether practically it happens very well, I really don't know. But normally what happens when you go and meet the assessing office, it's highly possible that you collide. You may what you call collide and you may just try to do the adjustment. Now, I file an appeal. It goes to different chains on 3-4 different routes. Maybe Bangalore you file. It may go to Kolkata. It may go to Kochi. It may go to Coimbatore. Different offices. Nobody knows from where it came on. Sometimes even PAN also will not be disclosed. In that scenario, how you should do the appeal? This is the explanation about that in section 250. However, so they made it as a parallel run, as of now, it's like a parallel run. Effectively, these things will happen effectively from, I think, after 1 or 2 years. Immediately, it's not going to happen because they need to test run the same. Fine. Then 254, orders of appellate tribunal for passing a stay order. Okay. You need to deposit, if you have to go for a stay order, at least 20% of the total tax, interest, fees, etc. as a security deposit. There's an amendment. 271 AAD, very, very dangerous amendment. That's why I made it green everywhere, including all of us, articles, chart accounts, if you involve RD 271 series is penalty. I'm expecting questions on this. Okay, MCQ penalties, old penalty project may be difficult for you to remember because too many penalty projects. But amended penalty provision, you remember 100% questions will come, 100%. If you involve in falsifying the books of account, so you simply interact with a cash account debit to sales account, 10 lakh. Penalty will be up to the amount of 10 lakh. So I, as an accountant, I have one more doubt, Niranjan. Penalty up to the aggregate of amount of such entry, they said. So cash account debit 10 lakh, so we to sales account 10 lakh, you have done a wrong entry. Sir, who will do sales, sir? Loan back, your income will be more. When loan repayment, income will be less. That's how tax cut back. That's why. So now tell me, cash account debit 10 lakh to sales account 10 lakh. So how much may be the penalty? Up to? I as an accountant may read as 20 lakh. Cash account debit 10 lakh to sales account 10 lakh. But that's not the intention of the law. They will levy up. Because the aggregate of the amount of such entry, cash account will 10 lakh, the sales account 10 lakh. Intentional, but someone can dispute this. Aggregate of the amount of such entry, aggregate is to 10 plus 10. What they are trying to say is, one entry cash account sales 10 lakh, one more entry cash account, purchase account to cash account 10 lakh. So each entry you have to add, that's what they mean. But there may be stupid interpretation like the way I did, saying what cash account 10 lakh to sales account 10 lakh. That also may happen. I don't know. Okay, right. Similar. So this is the procedural aspect. And 285B is about annual information statement. So where the department yesterday, what a beautiful WhatsApp again, saying that 2011, 12, etc. If you see the statements by the government, is hardly anyone is filing the income tax, hardly anyone is paying the tax. No one is paying the tax duty. Okay. So the India is, see, India, most of the things have to be done through the income tax collection. But recently, I think yesterday or 1 week back, the government has released the data. huge number of people are covered under the income tax net. That means those people were earlier also earning income but not paying the tax. Now thanks to the initiative taken by the government, they try to widen the tax base. So that's why they want to collect more and more information. So for, in this regard, one small amendment has happened. Now authorized representative section 288 subsection to NAMDU, okay, which is supposed to be from accountant, now legal practitioner, etc. also they were added. Then 295 is power to make rules. They will always make some amendment in relation to the procedural aspect. Now 295 is the last amendment as far as section is concerned. First schedule to the Income Tax Act talks about the insurance business. So there they have just inserted on a clarificatory amendment. 43B gives 43B. How to remember? I said 8 item. B looks like 8. Ikkada chudo. There are 8 items. They will be allowed purely when you pay it. 139(1) due date. If you pay later, it should be allowed the next year. So that provision was not existing under first schedule. When you do the insurance company income tax, insurance company IPCC, some of you studied. If I am a general insurance, reserve for unexpired is allowed to the extent of 100% of the premium received. If it is a marine related, 50% in the case of other general insurance. I repeat, section 44 of the Income Tax Act ready with the first schedule to the Income Tax Act. So if in the case of general insurance, 2 RMRs. If it is a marine means ocean related, risks are huge. That's why the reserve for unexpired risk allowed is 100% of the net to premium. That's allowed as reduction under Income Tax Act itself. Whereas if it is other than marine, 50% is allowed. So when you're computing that, sir, bonus was debited, so disallowed, what will happen? So that tenure, that normal provision you go. If there are some indirect taxes, insurance company has to pay GST. Your commission, etc. Will they add GST? And so you have seen the policy amount noted,
right? Yes, sir.
So that GST what is collected, they should be paid within 131 due date. If they don't pay, that will be added to their income. But however, next year when they pay, it is allowed as a deduction. Understood? Govinda, Govinda, these are about the budget amendments. Why did I do budget amendment before that revision? Because when we go to the problems, you should know these are the amendments which should be applied when I'm writing May 21 examination. Because some of the suggested answer I cannot change. Okay, so CS student has given the suggested answer. So these amendments you have to suitably bring it. That's what objective I have. So I think one of our friends from Kerala yesterday was asking, new friend. So material, mostly we'll circulate most of them through soft copy only. Don't worry, ma. Are you there? I think yesterday someone asked me that. So we'll circulate through soft copy only. So, but you give me 1 week, 10 days time. Okay, because all of our chart accounts are busy up to 15th January because of the tax audit report, etc. Fine. And maybe this corrected version also, I can send it. Anybody wants, okay, na? We'll discuss about it. Thank you very much. This is about the budget. 30 seconds, you can relax. Why should you relax? You're just a lot of seconds sitting. What relax? Allah. Able to see something?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
So till yesterday we discussed majority of the business income provisions. Now let us discuss about the problems, DT problems, whatever we're discussing. Okay. You know, someone challenged something, but it is not visible to me. You know, the Bhutakala. The font is okay.
Yes, sir.
You know, I saw yesterday. Font chikkadagidre ella idu line is it too big let control that Okay. So font is comfortable ba
but yes, yeah sir. Yes sir,
may become little maybe sakal sometimes because when you do the YouTube later on sometimes if the font is very small it will not visible adakoskara I'm just trying to increase the font but I think comfortable ba you are sure?
Yes sir.
Yes,
when tomorrow if I go like this is it too big? Okay, so there's one important section I thought I should discuss before we go to the capital gains. This is about manufacturing growing tea leaves and manufacturing tea in India. So you know RCT, rubber, coffee and tea. So the law itself, the rule 7, 7A, 7B and 8 itself has given a prescribed percentage. So for so all the cases, whenever you do both agricultural activity as well as non-agricultural activity. Agricultural activity is higher, business activity is lesser. So in the case of rubber, agriculture is 65%, coffee normally 75%. If you do roasting, etc., it will be 60%. Tea, it is agriculture is 60%. So anything else, fair market value of that produce used in the business shall be added to agriculture income and deducted from the business expenses. Deducted from the business income. So now if you are involved in the growing tea leaves and manufacturing tea powder in India, then there's an important section 33AB, read with the rule 7, etc. You have to incorporate. Beautiful section. I'll just touch it. You please practice this some little later. So for the previous year, 31st 2018, that is the, let us assume you are talking about a current year. It's composite business profits were before 11 and 33AB 60 lakh. Then it deposited 11 lakh rupees in a tea development account. During the previous year 16-17, it had a business loss of 14 lakh. And out of that 11 lakh rupees, okay, what did they do on it? Out of on 25-1-2019, it withdrew rupees 10 lakh. Dates, etc., please go through later because we don't have so much time to do it. 6 lakh rupees you used for purchase of a non-depreciable asset as per a scheme specified. The law only gives a clue to you. Scheme specified, they only told. That means when you withdraw, there's no default you're done. That means it's not going to be taxable. Normal provision is when you deposit, it will be allowance reduction. When you withdraw, two RMR. As per the scheme, it is not going to be taxable. If it is not as per the scheme, it is going to be taxable. So 3 lakh rupees purchase, you use it for purchase of machinery. If I stop here, then there is nothing wrong. But they have used it for what purpose? They use it for office premises. When they use for office premises, normally no deduction will be given. Whatever was given earlier, you are using it for a wrong purpose, it is going to be taxable. 1 lakh was sent for the purpose of purchase of scheme. Again, date not a vipress barbeco. It should have been used within 31st March 2019. 25-1-2019. So what is the last date of the previous year? 31st March 2019. That's the original section. I'm not teaching amendment. This section you should know. You used in the same previous year. You used after the previous year. That means actually you have done a blunder. That's why it is going to be added. Are you understanding? So that is what the table says here. Is it comfortable or is it too big?
Comfortable, sir.
Comfortable.
Okay. So, fine. So the 10 lakh rupees withdrawal, how is it going to be taxed? I said 6 lakh rupees, which is used, we have discussed now that point. We are using for whatever, it is not going to be. 3 lakh is taxable, 1 lakh is taxable. Then, again, out of this, very interesting. So, this I will not say taxable, I say income. Out of this 4 lakh, again, you have to do 60-40. Actually, 60% is agriculture, 40% is a beautiful question. Please solve it compulsorily. 60% is a business agriculture income, exempted. 40% is going to be business income. So how do you compute? There's a tax income. Income before that is 60 lakh. And amount allowed under 33AB is 40% of the profits of such business. 60 lakh into 40% is 24 lakh. or amount deposited in the T-Development account, TDA, 11 lakh, whichever less is 11 lakh. Then the income comes to 49 lakh, 60-40 you do it. What is 60% agriculture income and 40% business income. And against business income, this is a taxable income, you can adjust the brought forward loss. Business income against, business loss against only business income. That one beautiful question. Then this is about 40B computation. 40 small b talks about remuneration to partners, interest to partner. So if you are a PFES satisfying all the conditions of section 184, okay, then for all the partnership firm, including LLP, most of the provisions of the law are same for firm and LLP. One exception probably is 44AD. 44AD is applicable for resident individual, resident HF, resident partnership firm, not applicable to LLPs. Okay, then some conversion that UPC into LLP, itself, some amendment. Otherwise, firm and law LLP are same. 2 within bracket 23 says firm includes LLP. So 40 small b, 2 RMRs. Interest is allowed on any amount advised by the partner. So whether the capital, current account, loan, whatever given by the partner, as per the deed or simple interest at 12%, whichever is less, Whereas remuneration is allowed only to working partner. Look at me. Sir, amendment under 139.1 is over filing the return. But a remuneration is allowed only to working partner. So remuneration can be salary, fees, commission by whatever name called. So I normally say any payment made to the partner, 2 RMR. Rent to a building owned by him comes under section 30. Okay. So it is allowed under section 30 itself. Any other payment comes under 40B, 2 RMR, interest maximum 12%. And remuneration as per the working shown here. And in income tax value, always simple interest, no compound interest concept. So how do we compute? So net profit as per P&L, and be careful, we'll compute in that book profit. There are two book profits in your syllabus. One is a book profit at a 40 small b, then book profit at a 115 JB. Here book profit means income tax profit only. Normal profit as per chapter 4D, add back entire remuneration, whomever you're given, remuneration given to partner, but deduct interest on capital. Deduct interest on capital. So add interest, add salary, less interest they have deducted, because this was at 18% deducted. This is called book profit. So first 3 lakh, you have to go by 90% of the book profit or 1,50,000, whichever is higher. On the balance of the book profit, you have to go 60%. So this amount will be allowed. So assuming there are two partners, their remuneration as per the deed, are you listening? Remuneration as per the deed, in this case is 4,80,000. This or this, whichever less is allowed.
Sir, you are muted.
Fine. So moving on, shall we continue?
Yes, sir.
So relax. So I was trying to say the DHRS, I think you are writing in Jan 21, we'll give the material existing one. November 20 exam material is available. That material itself, we can give it to you. Fine. So 9,05,000 is a book profit. Computed book profit, computed remuneration 6,33,000 or 4,80,000, whichever is less. 6,33,000, 4,80,000, whichever less will be allowed. Assuming this amount would have been 6 lakh and 3 lakh, 9 lakh to two partner, then 9 lakh or 6,33, whichever less is 6,33,000. Then this 6,33,000 in the hands of the partner will be taxable as a business income in the ratio of 6:3. So whatever is allowed in the firm shall be income to the partners, 28 clause 5. So whatever is allowed, so interest to partner debited in the P&L account is 18%. Allowed is only 12%. Income to the partner is only 12%. What is allowed in the firm will become income. One man's expense is another person's income. If it is disallowed here, it cannot be income, income in the hands of partner, because the firm has already paid the taxes. Understood? Fine. So then again, a similar question. Okay. Now important point is 40B. Okay. So this is an important case law based question. Sir, remuneration, is it allowed? It must be mentioned in the deed. It should be specified in the deed. Either you should mention the amount, or at least the manner in which you compute the remuneration should be mentioned. If you don't do that, it is a disallowed. That is a case law based question on that. Then, okay. There's one more important amendment as far as WDV is concerned. So a company is using, growing and manufacturing tea in India. For those people, so if they're using a machinery, etc., partly for agriculture, partly for business, what to do? Explanation 7 has been added around 3 years back, saying that compute the depreciation as if it's fully used for business. Then 60-40, whatever the percentage you want to do it, you do it. Next year, WDV computation should be by deducting entire depreciation as if it was fully used for business purpose. That is what the point. So, plant and machinery is 52 lakh minus 15% you do, 44.2. You should do complete 100% depreciation. You should claim it. Don't do 60-40. One more head. Capital gains. Capital gains stock is transfer plus capital asset is equal to capital gain. 2 within bracket 47 defines transfer plus 214 capital asset is equal to capital gain under section 45. Now, these capital gains can be two RMRs, long term or short term. 2 within bracket 42A defines what is a short term capital asset. Short term capital assets are normally the assets held for less than or equal to 36 months, whereas unlisted shares, security shares and LBB, it is 24 months. Loser, listed security, units of UTI, units of mutual fund and zero coupon bond, for them it is 12 months. For less than or equal to 12 months, it is going to be short term. Held for more than that period, it is going to be long term. So normally short term capital asset leads to short term capital gain. Normally long term capital asset leads to long term capital gain. But there are some exceptions here. Section 50, a building which has been held for 4 years, 10 years, it is obviously long term capital asset. But since it's a depreciable asset, capital gain is always going to be short term. So there's a possibility of a short term capital gain arising on long term capital asset. And 54EC, can I claim an exemption? Answer is yes. Because 54EC says you should have transferred long term capital asset. That means depreciable asset in section 50, which are coming under section 50, they will also get an exemption. They will also get an exemption as long as they were long term. So building held for 18 months, it is going to be short-term capital asset, short-term capital. Building held for 4 years, long-term capital asset, short-term capital gain. Eligible for 54EC exemption. Understood? Fine. Now, 247 is transfer. Section 47?
No transfer.
No transfer.
No transfer. Anyway, so now let us get into the slump sale. What is slump sale? Whenever an undertaking unit or a division or a company as a whole has been sold without assigning values to individual assets and liabilities. That is what is called slump sale. Easy to remember, I told you. Slump means lump sum. A unit has been sold for a lump sum consideration. That's called slump sale. So what you should do? Take the sale value minus net worth of the undertaking accounts. Assets minus external liabilities. How do you value the asset? 35 AD asset, 100% your claim reduction there, zero. Depreciable asset, you take a WDV. All other assets and liabilities should be taken into book value. The word revaluation is unheard in income tax. If there's a revaluation effected, you reverse the revaluation. If they added minus karo, minus kya to add karo. Samajh mein aa raha hai? So there are multiple questions on this, sir. So lump sum consideration is 88 lakh. So they are given some information about revaluation here. You can just look at this. Okay. Then other fixed asset, book value, etc. have been given. So presentation of the same. First, you should do the net worth. Not this. You should go for the net worth computation. So book value of non-depreciable asset. Revaluation has to be removed. First, you do that. Mathematically, you do it. WDV of the depreciable asset. The total minus book value of the liability. This is 770 is the net worth of the undertaking or unit. Sale value 880 minus 770, 110 is the capital gain. If the undertaking was in existence for more than 36 months, then it will be long term. If it is less than 36 months or equal to 36 months, it's always going to be short term. Sir, what about land 24 months, nothing doing here? Undertaking more than 36 months, long term. That's it. And no indexation for net worth. How do you do it here? Because assets would have been purchased at a different period. So this is about that and taxation in the usual manner. Fine. Then, the dividend stripping, yesterday I think I discussed about that. Let me not waste much time on that again. Okay. So conversion. Oh, this is an important law. Okay. Conversion. Converting. Michael Jackson. Huh? male into female, female into male, alla. So conversion to RMRs. So Shetty sir, furniture dealer, has purchased a land. Land is a capital asset. Conversion of capital asset into stock into it. I start real estate business. 45 subsection 2. So in 2010, I purchased the land at 100 lakh, which is a capital asset. 2015, its market value, fair market value is the word used, is 150 lakh. 2020, I sold the same at, let's say, 180 lakh. Common sense approach, 100 lakh to 150 to the capital asset. That means 50 lakh increase is the capital gain. 150 to 180, it was a business asset, a stock in trade, that should be a business income. So 45.2 says, in the year of actual sale of stock in trade, in the year of actual year of stock in trade, that is in 2020, two RMRs. So actual sale value, how much? 180 minus the fair market value, 30 lakh will be business income. 150 lakh, that is on the date of the transfer, minus indexed cost up to 2015. Because the transfer is complete in the year of a conversion. So numerator should be only of the indexation of the year of a transfer, that is a 2015. So 150 minus indexed cost of 100 lakh is equal to capital gain. Understood, my dear friends? This is about conversion of capital asset into stock in trade. Ulta case, conversion of stock in trade into capital asset. Shetty sir is a real estate icon, gunda. Okay. So I am doing real estate businessman. I'm doing real estate business. I'm not doing real estate businessman. I am a real estate businessman. I am a real estate businessman. Correction, madam. Slow. Now, I have a land which was purchased in 2010 for 100 lakh. Same example. I converted this stock in trade into capital asset. Let's say in 2018, because this law came very recently. 2015, this law was not there. I know that. You may not be knowing. I am telling you. 2018. On that date, 150 lakh is the fair market value. Sold in 2020 at a capital asset. So 2010 it was a stock, 2018 it is a stock, converted into capital asset. This is a dangerous provision. 28, which is the bracket 6 years, in the year of conversion of stock in trade into capital asset, what is the fair market value? Fair market value, let's say 150 lakh minus the cost 100 lakh will be called business income. Business income will indexation concept in a long term, short term. From 2018 to 2020, 150 has become a, what do you call, 180 lakh. So that will be taxed as a capital gain. So be careful. Conversion of capital is stock in trade, both the incomes in the year of actual sale. Whereas conversion of stock in trade into capital asset, two different incomes in two different years. 2018, it is going to be a business income. 2020, it is going to be a capital gains. Have you understood, my dear friends?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Thank you very much. So that's the presentation I given, fair market value, index cost, etc. So here there's a proportional concept because they are sold only 2/3. So there are two ways you can do it. First, you compute like this entire calculation model. What they sold is 2/3, 2/3 capital gain you take. Athava, all the calculation you do it for 2/3 only. Did you hear? Fine. And 54 EC exemption, 50 lakh, only if you invest in 4 bonds, NHA, RECL, PFC, and Indian Railway Corporation. Okay. The bonds to road transportation. Yaudo, NHA and Indian Railway, which is a financing company, obviously. And then electricity related, power related, Power Finance Corporation and Indian,
RECL.
RECL.
Rural Electrification Corporation Limited. Maximum exemption in a financial year, now it's been amended to, in this respect of that particular expend year and capital gain, 50 lakh. Earlier used to claim 100 lakh in that mechanism, now it's only 50 lakh rupees. Fair enough. So the working notes are what they give, lot of working notes on that. You also learn to give the working notes. These are all the examination question. 54F, this is an interesting question. Please go through based on one Delhi High Court decision, Geeta Dugal case, where if you construct, okay, if you construct three floors, okay, and you are receiving 5 crore as a consideration for the sale, and you get three other units. What are the consideration? That's why look at me. Don't forget, don't bother about that. Section 48, computation, the first sentence, full value of sale consideration. What is full value of sale consideration? What is received in cash? What is received in kind? Everything has to be added. That is the meaning of this, what you call the question. This is again, same 45.2. This is again a slum sale problem. Slum sale question has been asked multiple times. Okay. go through it. I'll not multiple questions. I don't want to get into that. Okay. This one question for me, not for you. Income from other source also they will ask. Okay. So there 56-210 every year there's an amendment. I'll not go to the question, but at least look at the answer. Cash gift received in excess of 50,000 rupees fully taxable. Bullion is all okay. Wait. 56-210 received by any person from any persons, any of the three assets only, cash gift above 50,000 rupees in aggregate. LBB, stamp value minus Z. Last one, Bij or Pass. In caps we say Bij or Pass. What is Bij or Pass? Bullion, jewelry, archaeological collection, drawings, paintings, work of art, sculpture, shares and securities. So what is the difference between 56-210 and 214 capital asset definition? Capital asset definition, we use the word only Jadpas, J-A-D-P-A-S. B, bullion, anyhow, everybody knows it's a capital asset. Shares and securities are also capital asset. I hope you remember the discussion.
Yes, sir.
Well, no, brilliant. So only these assets are covered. That means if a car is gifted to me by Chinmay, car is not covered in that asset. So our car is 20 lakh worth of car has been gifted by her. It is not going to be taxable. It is not going to be taxable. So the income which are going to be taxable are cash gift, only three categories. Cash gift. Cash includes check, obviously. Then immovable property being LBM, you know, LBB. Land, building, or
both.
Land, building, or both. Stamp value minus Z. And BJ pass, fair market value minus Z. BJ pass, you know, fair. So anything else is not covered by hard net. First point. And each case 50,000 limit is there. Each case 50,000 limit is there. Fine. And two special amendments as per the LBB is concerned. So 110%, up to 110% if it is the stamp value, it's absolutely fine. Okay. Then for 2021 May exam, I'm telling. Then whereas January 21, it is only 5%, not 110%. Then date of agreement and date of deed obviously will not be same. So if the which stamp value you have to consider? You can consider stamp value on the date of agreement if and only if two conditions are satisfied. At least some consideration, at least some consideration, you should have received. Are you listening, all of you? Yeah. Not relevant in your Aguda. At least some consideration you should have received on or before the date of agreement and any mode other than cash. Account pay, check, account pay, draft, etc. You should have received. If you receive in cash, they will say, I'll not consider. I'll go by the stamp value on the date of deed itself. But interesting point is, Niranjan, if agreement date, the stamp value is 40 lakh, on the date of registration of deed, it will come down to 35 lakh, still you can get the benefit. Because the law is not told which are higher helila. Okay. It's a very rare case which comes down, but you can get the benefit. So cash gift taxable. Bullion is covered. Plot of land. Stamp value. Consider stamp value. Then the question not going to go there. Stock in trade is a business asset. Why the hell it will come under other source? Other source will borrow only if it not coming under other earlier four heads of income or specifically mentioned. Then the last case is difference between stamp value and consideration received. Z in our language, Z is consideration, is it? Is going to be taxable. All these are income from other sources because 56 is a charging section of others 56-210. Well, then there's a capital gain computation. So one important, okay, wait. I receive a gift from Niranjan, who is not my relative. So for him, so the cost of the land is 100 lakh. He gifted it to me on which the stamp value is 300 lakh. Gift is never a transfer. As per section 47 within the bracket III. Unless it is a ESOP as per central government securities, as per proviso to 47.3. Enjoy. So 47.3, he gifted a land. For him, there is no capital gain. Gift is never a transfer under capital gain except a ESOP. ESOP should not be gifted. If you gift, it is going to be taxable. So for him, no problem. He is not my relative. So then the law says stamp value 300 lakh minus 20 lakh I paid him on Kode. Then 300 lakh minus 20 lakh, 280 lakh is the income from other source, 56-210. Understood. Gift income. Subsequently, when I sell that, 49 subsection 4, this section says, my cost, assuming I sold subsequently to Prajna at 360 lakh. 360 lakh minus how much? In my example.
Original cost.
300
lakh. Or original cost to Niranjan. Three answers for a chance. Niranjan cost 100 lakh.
300
lakh. Entire stamp value. Entire 300 lakh, not 100, not 280, entire 300 lakh has to be minus. Understood. That is under section 49, subsection 4. Whereas I receive a gift from Surabhi, who is my relative. So 100 lakh, same example. So no tax to Surabhi, relative or not, Badmega, capital gain, no concept of relative. Then for Surabhi, no income. For Shetty sir, no income because she's my relative. Right. Then when I sell the same subsequently, cost to me is cost to the previous owner under section 49, subsection 1. And special point is, advance money forfeited should be reduced only if it is on the present owner. Previous owner, you should not reduce the same. Understanding, my dear friends? Fair enough. Next. Oh, this is one beautiful question. This class I discussed for the benefit of my new friends. I repeat, there is no clubbing of income arising out of the clubbed income. One sentence. That's it. So, any transaction is the wife, okay, financial transaction, I'm telling Niranjan, okay, is not suggested. Because any transaction, so I receive gift for my wife, 60,000 rupees. She is my relative, no doubt. But clubbing will come. Clubbing overrides a gift provisions. Clubbing will be attracted. So if I receive any gift from my relative, it is a relative, no problem. But if it is spouse, dangerous. So there is a section where they say, example, beautiful question, practice again, where income which has been transferred to you, it is going to be clubbed. Out of that, that person, again, if she gets some interest, that income will not be clubbed. For example, in this case, so 2,000 worth of debentures have been transferred by one person to another person, being couple, spouse. The out of the 30,000 interest has been earned, 30,000 is going to be clubbed. Our 30,000 income, Anna, the other person who received, if she invests in FD and if she earns 3,000, that will not be clubbed. That is the sum and substance of this question. Oh, this is one more beauty. So relaxation, relax, sir, exception. Quickly, Odi.
Miss Purna held 12% equity shares in Omnicon Private Limited.
She is not private limited. Statue. So moment you see the name, nature, date, be careful. So private limited means X company. Company which public are not substantially interested.
Public are not interested. She gifted all the shares held by her in Omnicon Private Limited to her husband, Mr. Suresh, on 14-9-2017. There was no consideration involved in such transaction. On 5-11-2017, Mr. Suresh obtained a loan of 5 lakhs from Omnicon Private Limited when the company's accumulated profit was 4 lakhs. What are the tax implications?
Illi, on the clubbing. So because she gifted to her husband. Husband is what you call the clubbing project 64. Then 222E. Whenever you take a loan from a company which the vibration bar back, 10% or more. 10% or more. Okay. So when you receive any loan from a X company, that the company which public are not substantially interested, it is going to be deemed dividend section 222E. So first section 222E, very interesting, beautifully planned structure. But what happens, you look at the answer. Quickly read the answer. 222 is applicable if a registered shareholder. So these are a question. You have to write a chart of company, two RMRs. Who is the original owner? Whom it is transferred? Who is the registered owner? How it gets? Keep on writing the chart. You'll get a flow like this. 222E, I will read. Closely held company, etc. They are given the point. To attract the same, recipient should be the registered shareholder. In Devro, it should be a registered shareholder. So in the given case, who is the registered shareholder? She gifted all the shares by her. So Purna was holding 12%. She gifted to her husband, Suresh. Who is the registered shareholder? Suresh. There was no consideration involved. On 15, Mr. Suresh obtained a loan and he is a registered shareholder. Accordingly, the 4 lakh rupees would be deemed dividend in the hands of Mr. Suresh. I'm going a little faster. I hope you're able to catch. Artak Telia?
Yes.
Who holds 12%? Next. Thereafter, clubbing provisions will attract. You know, income arises directly. They have just reiterated the provision. So they normally they will write the law and then they'll explain. If the assets are transferred or shares in a company, the loan taken from the company is deemed as dividend in the hands of the person to the extent of accumulated profit. Thus, on account of deeming provision, such loan is treated as income arising from the shares. It was so held by what a high court decision. So, Ilina Oji, sir.
Accordingly, as per section 64(1), clause 4, such income arising in the hands of shareholder Mr. Suresh by virtue of section 222E, that is deemed dividend of 4 lakhs, would be included in the total income of Purna, who had transferred the said shares to Mr. Suresh without consideration.
You point Artha, did you understand that case?
Yes, sir.
Purna was the original shareholder. ಶಿ ಗಿಫ್ಟೆಡ್ ಇಟ್ ಟು ಹರ್ ಹಸ್ಬೆಂಡ್. ಸೊ ಇದು ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಪೂರ್ಣ ಹೋಗ್ಬಿಟ್ಟು ಚೂರ್ಣ ಆಗ್ಬಿಡ್ತಿಲ್ಲಿ. ಸೊ ಚೂರ್ಣ ರಿಸೀವ್ಡ್, ಚೂರ್ಣ ಇದು ಹಸ್ಬೆಂಡ್ಸ್ ನೇಮ್ ಅಂತ ಅಂದ್ಕೊಡಿ. ಈ ರಿಸೀವ್ಡ್ ದ ಶೇರ್. ಸೊ ಆಸ್ ಪರ್ ಒನ್ ಲಾ, ಸೊ ಈ ಇಸ್ ಅ ಶೇರ್ ಹೋಲ್ಡರ್, ಸೊ ಈ ಶುಡ್ ಗೆಟ್ ಎ ಡಿವಿಡೆಂಡ್. ಬಟ್ ಶಿ ಹಸ್ ಗಿಫ್ಟೆಡ್ ಇಟ್ ಟು ಹಿಮ್ ವಿದೌಟ್ ಕನ್ಸಿಡರೇಷನ್. ಸೊ ಇನ್ಕಮ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಅಗೇನ್ ಬ್ಯಾಕ್ ಟು ಮಿಸ್ ಪೂರ್ಣ ಇಟ್ ಸರ್. ಮಿಸ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಎಮ್ ಎಸ್ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಮಿಸ್ ಅಥವಾ ಮಿಸ್ಸಸ್ ಆಯ್ತಾ, ಎಮ್ ಎಸ್ ಎಮ್ ಐ ಎಸ್ ಎಸ್ ಅಲ್ಲ. ದಟ್ ದ ವೇ ಪಡ್ಕೊಂಡು ನೀವು ಡೆವಲಪ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಇನ್ ಇಂಗ್ಲಿಷ್ ನೀವು ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಮೇ ಬಿ 10-20 ಇಯರ್ಸ್ ಆಗಿರ್ಬೋದು ಗೊತ್ತಿಲ್ಲ. ನಾರ್ಮಲಿ ನಿರಂಜನ್ ಬಿಫೋರ್ ಮ್ಯಾರೇಜ್ ಮಿಸ್ಟರ್, ಆಫ್ಟರ್ ಮ್ಯಾರೇಜ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಮಿಸ್ಟರ್. ಏ ಗರ್ಲ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ಸೇಯಿಂಗ್ ವೈ, ಸೊ ಐ ಆಮ್ ಮಿಸ್ ಬಿಫೋರ್ ಆಫ್ಟರ್ ಮಿಸ್ಸಸ್ ಏನಕ್ಕೆ? ಐ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಡೋಂಟ್ ವಾಂಟ್ ಟು ಡಿಸ್ಕ್ಲೋಸ್ ಮೈ ಮ್ಯಾರೇಜ್ ಸ್ಟಾಟಸ್. ದೆನ್ ಕಾಯಿನ್ ಒಂದು ವರ್ಡ್ ಕಾಲ್ ಎಂ ಎಸ್. ಎಂ ಬಾರ್ ಎಸ್ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಕ್ಯಾಪ್ಸ್ ಅಥವಾ ಐ ಸಿ ಐ ಮೆಸಸ್. ಇದು ಎಂ ಎಸ್ ಇರ್ಲಿ ನಿಮ್ಗೊಂದು ಎಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ರಾ ನಾಲೆಜ್ ಗೊತ್ತಿರೋದೆ. ಸೆಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಕ್ಯಾರಿ ಫಾರ್ವರ್ಡ್, ಲುಕ್ ಅಟ್ ಮೀ, ತ್ರೀ ಅನ್ಅಬ್ಸಾರ್ಬ್ಡ್ ಅಲವೆನ್ಸಸ್, 32-2 depreciation, any depreciation, 35-4 only for capital expenditure referred in 35-1-4 for any SSC, 36-1-9 only for company family planning. All this if they are unabsorbed, okay, it will be added to the next year's respective expenditure, and you can keep on carrying forward like this for year after year after year, and can adjust against any income in any year except salary 71-2A. 73 capital A, 35 AD case. So if there is unabsorbed loss because of the 14 specified businesses, capital expenditure only, except LGF. This can be carried forward for any number of years, but adjust only against those 14 businesses. In all other cases, 70-80 says you can set off in the current year normally against any income, but carry forward normally for 8 years to be adjusted only against respective income. One or two special points to be noted. Salary there cannot be lost. House property loss in the current year can be adjusted against any other head of income. Head of income, 71-3A, only 2 lakh. Whereas business income, only speculation loss cannot be adjusted against any other head. Then speculation profit is touchable. Speculation loss is untouchable. That means Pani Puri loss, speculation profit set off is permissible. Speculation loss, Pan Bida profit set off is not permissible. Understanding?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Fine. Next, business losses cannot be adjusted against salary income. Depreciation also should not be adjusted against salary income. Then small tumbler, capital gains. Small tumbler can be kept in the big tumbler. Big tumbler will not fit into the small tumbler. It means short-term capital loss can be adjusted against short-term or long-term capital gain. Where long-term capital loss cannot be adjusted in short-term in the current year as well as in the year of carry-forward and set-off. Other source, two RMRs. Resource loss can be adjusted only against resource income. Any other case, there can be a loss. Many people don't have this knowledge. See, other source, how can it be lost? Interest received, temporary interest received 10 lakh, interest paid 14 lakh, 4 lakh loss can be adjusted against any other head in the current year. However, there is no carry-forward provision because there is no specific mention. 72A, beautiful section of amalgamation, demerger, etc. Whenever there's an amalgamation, you can, so B Limited, mainly for a manufacturing company, company owning ship, hotel, etc. B Limited has carry forward business loss. You can, amalgamation, only two losses are covered. One is a business loss, then unabsorbed allowances, including depreciation. Now, whenever there is a business loss, B Limited, 7 years it carry forward, 8 years it gets merged with A Limited. So in the 8th year, business loss of B Limited will be considered as current year business loss of A Limited. That means it can be adjusted against any other head of income in that year, year of setup. But carry forward next again 8 years to be adjusted only against a business income. Understanding? Fine. So this is a provision about a setup and carry forward. Then the 72A, there's an amalgamation what I'm selling. Amalgamation conditions, etc. should be satisfied. Then 78 subsection 1. Whenever there is a retirement or death, okay, of a partner, its share of loss cannot be carried forward. Its share of loss cannot be carried forward. 78 subsection 1. Then procedural aspect, ATIA computation. Okay, they are given ETIL, AMT. Okay, before I forget, see, I think there are some students who are writing in January 2021 cycle. Please stay back. At the end, I will tell you what material has to be used on. That is also law is these provisions are same. What are the problems I'm explaining? They are same. Well, amendments are not applicable. At the end, I'll explain about it. Just stay back because I'm in a flow. I don't want to disturb my flow. Now, AMT and MAT, which comes a little later. MAT 115JB, compute book profit in a true sense book profit, add 15 items minus 13 plus 1 item, that profit into two RMRs. Normal tax you have to compute. What are the normal income tax you have computed? Normal tax, X. Book profit into 15% applicable surcharge. Be careful. If assuming your normal income is 90 lakh, no surcharge, you're a company. If your book profit is 110 lakh, there is 7% surcharge if you're a domestic company. Understanding? Because your book profit is deemed total income. So normal total income, normal tax, X. Book profit into 15% plus surcharge, blah, blah. Now, Y. Whichever is higher. If X comes to 4 lakh and Y comes to 8 lakh, whichever is higher is 8 lakh, MAT is applicable. Then Y minus X is called MAT credit to be carried for next 15 years. Okay. So that can be carried for 15 years. Next, 15 years. Whereas if you are non-corporate, 115JB is for only corporate, including foreign company. If you are a non-corporate, individual, HF, firm, LLP, anybody, you come under AMT, AMTECAI, alternate minimum tax, okay, 115JC. Here, normal income tax, X. Adjusted total income, this is also income tax income. It is not a book profit. Into 18.5%, there is no change in this law, okay? Stay there, okay? Fine. Only IFSC in both the cases, it is 9%. If it's a IFSC unit, is 9%. Be careful, see that wording, sir. So, adjusted, what is adjusted total income? Compute the normal total income, add back 10AA, add back chapter 6AC, income based reduction, add back 35AD after reducing section 32. So, do that. So, into 18.5%, whichever is higher, again, Y minus X. If you are an individual HF, etc., being a slab based SSC, if your adjusted total income is less than or equal to 20 lakh, AMT is not applicable to you. Understood? So here they have done a normal computation. Gross total income, ETIA information is given there. So 200 lakh, 100 lakh, otherwise 30% because it's a partnership form. Are you listening? Yeah. So then do the whatever. Fine. So then how do you do the AMT? 100 lakh is the total income. Add back what has been deducted. Add back only three items. Add back only three items. Are you listening? So add back on that 18.5%, 15% Allah, 18.5%, then whatever. So whichever is higher. So if you look at the normal tax, it came to 31.2 and AMT came to 64 lakh. That means AMT is applicable. 64 minus 31 will be considered the AMT credit to be carried for how many years? 15 years. That is the presentation what has been shown here. Arthaita. And you need to file the report within the due date. Now, amendment prakara, specified date. Otherwise, you should file within the due date. Fair enough. There's one more question which is very, very commonly asked. Compulsorily solve one. I think I've given at least 4 or 5 questions. Compulsorily solve this kind of questions. Each question only, 90% items are same. One adjustment. One question they give ATD, one question they give ATC, some other question, something else, chapter 6. Everything else is similar. I'll quickly go through. It is about section 91, international taxation. 30% of the syllabus in 7th paper is international taxation. That's why normally we suggested CAPS, 6th paper you take international taxation. So that little extra reading automatically taken care of the 6th paper. And there's an open book exam. Open book exam will not be easy. Don't take light it. Don't take lightly. If you ask me, 7th paper is easier than the 6th paper, okay? Any paper, some people try, adu martini, idu martini, global alla, mathe vapas banbittu, they came, finished the international taxation. Irli. Now, Mr. Whatever, Miss Vivita, sometimes you look at the age, illi 25 giddo, inon question 62 quoted thara, then the senior citizen agirbeko. Arthakta, 3 lakh. Otherwise, almost everything is same, everything is similar. Just 1 second. Burning sensation there. I don't know where. Outside. Check if anybody is smoking cigarette nearby. Yeah, anyway. So, when you talk about the Nimanetra, check what the end is. Yeah. ಆನ್ಲೈನ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಬರುತ್ತೆ ಅದು ಹೋಗಿ ಮಾಡ್ತಾರೆ. ಒನ್ ಸೆಕೆಂಡ್, ಜಸ್ಟ್ ಒನ್ ಸೆಕೆಂಡ್, ಲಾಸ್ಟ್ ಇನ್ಕಮ್. Yeah, anyway, let us continue. You cannot. So earning income from playing snooker in country L, 12 lakh. Tax paid then 1.8. Immediately you should know 15% of tax. Income from snooker in India, 19.2. Then LIC premium, medical insurance, etc. is there. Okay. Paid for a father, 62 years. Okay. You know, ATD limit is there. Okay. Na? So compute, how do you do the 91, section 91 relief? So first compute the all income as if mera baap ka mala, everything you add, foreign income, Indian income, everything you add. Give deductions. This is where I said they change. Almost every other question will be similar in nature. So ATC, okay, what is the maximum amount allowed? 1,50,000. Now they are given only 1,10,000. ATD, senior citizen, you can go up to 50,000 rupees. Claim the same, compute the tax. Normal tax computation, you should know. This tax computation, total tax divided by total income is called average rate of tax definition. This comes to 24.61%, but the tax paid in the foreign country is only 15%. Whichever is less will be given as a relief under section 91. So if the foreign income is 12 lakh into 15%, this is a relief for the differential amount of tax paid. I think you understood.
Yes.
A similar question is going to be asked. Yeah. And very, very important. If it is a 6-mark question, most of the time, you lose 3 marks if you don't write this note. Compulsory, you have to write this note. Okay. She is presumed to be resident in India if no information is given. Because if you're non-resident, foreign income, why is it taxable? Only if you're R&OR, global income is taxable. I hope you're understanding. And all these notes, what they're given, and you should give, including saying that we presume that there's no agreement. Because if there's an agreement, section 90 comes. When there's no agreement, section 91 comes into picture. Are you getting my point? So similarly, all questions they have done like this. Previous question, your question, difference in that. Only Vivita, in Valisha, ATD quota, and ATCC general section, they have given that extra question. Are you there? Extra deduction. Almost everything else is same. One special point I want to mention. If they are having income in two different countries, so please give reduction, average rate of tax in India or country X, which are less. Average rate of tax in India, country Y, which are less. Don't try to average those foreign two foreign countries. So country X only 12%, country Y only 15%. Don't be average. Individually, you have to give. That's a special point to be noted. Can I continue? Yeah. They're all related to the same. See, look at this. Only this chapter 60 reduction change after the extra amendment. So 2-3 questions if you do, it's similar in nature. Sustaita. Next comes transfer pricing. So international transfer pricing, where at least one person involved is non-resident. Domestic transfer pricing, 92BA, okay, basically meant for resident. Domestic transfer pricing is applicable only when the total income is exceeding 20 crores. Okay, 20 crores, then repeat code. So a mechanism are similar. So 92A, two RMRs. Subsection 1 defines what is associated enterprise. MCC, when you are having you are participating in management, control and capital. So you are called associate enterprise. 92A subsection 2 gives a list of deemed associate enterprises which you must go through clause by clause. Must go through share capital related, purchase related, sales related, like that. Go through money. First one. Then 92C gives 6 methods of computation of ALP, arm's length price. So how do you compute? Like that, every examination, 6 to 8 marks, there will be some question on transfer pricing. Okay, basic, 2 high-5 beta, basic. Okay, what is an associated enterprise? What is arm's length price? So how do you compute to FOB, CIF value? How do you do? There's a presentation, just glance it once. Fine. Then this question I would expect all of you to practice. Safe harbor rules. Okay, so whether, how do I go for this safe harbor rules computation? Beautiful table approach question is there. Go through money. There is explanation of the same though, same question. The detailed explanation is there. Again, CIF filter. taxation of non-resident. So special provision, one question about 6 marks, 115 BA, 115 BBA, ella barute. Like if you are a non-resident sports person, so yaar idare ga ABD units, ABD, okay, South Africa, he comes, he plays in IPL, etc. in India. Okay, in that case, how is it taxable? So 115 BBA says, any income from this, what you call, any income earned from the sports activity shall be taxable at 20%. Okay. Whereas if there's a lottery income, whether you are an individual, resident, non-resident, everybody is taxed at 30%. Go by that and do the calculation. Right. Next, if he's a referee, sports person doesn't cover referee varodilla. Referee is not covered. There is an examination question based on referee. Okay, fine. Now, if there are some analytical questions of assessment procedure, etc., how do we answer? You have to go by IPAC order. IPAC issues, you have to go one by one step. Issues covered, provisions of the law, analysis of the question given, conclusion. IPAC, IPAC. At the end, I think that point is also there, covered in the material. IPAC and Reno, issues covered, provisions, analysis, and conclusion. That is the way you should analyze the case. In the assessment related questions, how, if this is the case, what is the answer? If that is the case, what is the answer? The question can tell. I'll not get into all theoretical procedural aspect. Please go through. And one question compulsory on TDS. Compulsory. So if there is no TDS question, there is not examination. And this, especially this time, 100% there will be multiple questions on TDS and TCS. Look at the way they coin the question. First point, what is that?
Mr. X, a resident, acquired a house property at Mumbai from Mr. Y for a consideration of 90 lakhs. On 2/6/2018, on the same day, Mr. X made two separate transactions, thereby acquiring an urban plot in Kolkata from Mr. C for a sum of 49,50,000 and rural agricultural land from Mr. D for a consideration of 60 lakh.
So first, your purchase a property, 90 lakh, above 50 lakh rupees already for IAS if you do the TDS. At what rate?
1%.
Whereas if it is a non-urban agricultural land, non-urban, the last one, rural is not a right word, non-urban agricultural land, it is not a capital asset, it is not a capital gain. Why there is a TDS? TDS is only on income. There is no TDS provision. Whereas urban agricultural land, TDS should have been done when it is below 50 lakh. Less than 50 lakh. He is right. There is no TDS. Artha
Ita. Yes, sir.
So like that, they will be given lot of questions. Not really. So first case, 90 lakh into 1%. Next two cases, well, it is not there. 184 IA. So commission, all commission case above 15,000, you have to do 5% TDS, I said, which includes even consignee commission. Commission paid or commission deducted by the payee. She pay, deducts and then if she, what you call, remit the balance amount, then TDS is applicable. 184B is about TDS on lottery, etc. And if you earn in kind, proviso to 184B. Correction, earlier it used to be second proviso. Now one proviso has been removed. Now it's called proviso to 184B. If you earn lottery in kind, either the lottery winning person should have paid a tax by himself and give the proof to the lottery agency, or give the money to the lottery agency, then only they can release the assets. 182, salary computation, be careful, be extremely careful. Many people don't know about the certain provisions. Compute the normal salary, give only house property loss deduction, add every other income. Chapter 6A, all deductions are not allowed. Normal ITR filing, everything is allowed. But here only prescribed deductions are considered. For example, you talk about ETG. Donation given to Swachh Bharat Kosh allowed. Under TDS computation also, ITR also. Donation given to CAPS Foundation, you should not deduct it when it comes to the TDS under 192. But ITR claiming, you can always do that. All TDS related question. Yeah, MAT and alternative analytical question it is about. EMT na madavala, we just did it. EMT, idon question, we'll just explain. MAT, Sona Limited, abhi to Sona nahi hai, don't Sona. Okay, so idon tara, Kuldeep house ki one thief entered and asked, night, in chaku tos bitu, he asked, hey Sona kidare anta. Anyway, revision class and jokes are like time irodilla, but still. So Kuldeep gen kelidana, Sona kidare. So Kuldeep says, itna bada ghar hai bhai, kidhar bhi so ja, kyon pooch rahe ho? ಆತರ ಆ ಸೋನ ಬೇರೆ ಈ ಸೋನ ಬೇರೆ ಶೋಣ ಶೋಣ ನಾವು ಮ್ಯಾಟ್ ಕಂಪಿಟೇಷನ್ ಇಸ್ ಬೇಸ್ ಆನ್ ದ ಬುಕ್ ಪ್ರಾಫಿಟ್ ಆಸ್ ಡಿಫೈನ್ಡ್ ಇನ್ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪ್ಲನೇಷನ್ ಬಿಲೋ 115JB ಸಬ್ಸೆಕ್ಷನ್ 2 ಸೊ ಬುಕ್ ಪ್ರಾಫಿಟ್ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ನೆಟ್ ಪ್ರಾಫಿಟ್ ಆಸ್ ಪರ್ ಪೇಡ್ ಅಕೌಂಟ್ ಆಡ್ 15 ಐಟಮ್ಸ್ ಮೈನಸ್ 13 ಪ್ಲಸ್ 1 So now you have to tell me whether these items have to be added or not from the knowledge what you have. Provision for loss of subsidiary company. I have given a beautiful table about that. Okay. Loss of subsidiary company. Add or less?
Nothing.
Add.
Nothing. Add.
Add. Add. Niranjan. Add. 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 Item. Loss of a subsidiary company is a special item. I said it's a stupid item in Indian context. With example explanation put in it. Loss of a subsidiary company, you should add back.
Add back.
Because it's a contract for it. Okay. Provision for doubtful debts. Really?
Not.
Should we add back only if it is unascertained? It is ascertained liability, should not. Okay. Provision for income tax.
Add.
Provision for gratuity based on actual valuation should not
should
add.
Should not.
Depreciation compulsorily add.
Add.
Interest financial institution not paid within 131 due date. What is 3B? Ignore.
No, nothing to be done.
131 penalty for infraction of law. No provision which is added back. Not add. We're talking about book property. Kelsta ji, the devro?
Yes, sir.
Then depreciation include 150,000 on account of revaluation. So add back entire depreciation minus whatever amount to minus 150,000 because accounting depreciation has to be minus. This is not relevant.
Not true, sir.
Brought forward loss of 10 lakh which includes unemployed depreciation of 4 lakh. Income tax brought forward loss should not be considered. Only accounting loss has to be considered. Capital gain has been invested in, therefore normal competition, 54 ECA. The AOP of which company is a member has paid a tax at maximum marginal rate. If they have paid maximum marginal rate, that income is not going to be taxable.
Taxed.
Okay. Items created, I'm sorry, correct. Profit from SEZ unit, 10AA, what you should do?
Ignore.
Close your eyes.
Very good. Excellent, Suthi. I love it. Close your eyes. That's what I said. Close your eyes. Because it is matable. Add madangila minus madangila. It should be, it is matable. Ignore it. Share of income of AOP, if the AOP has paid a maximum margin rate, it should be excluded. That means it's credit to pay an account minus money.
Minus.
Income from units of UTI. Earlier, we had that mutual fund, etc. exemption, 1035. Now it is not exempted. So, this I think might require an amendment in the answer. Then long-term capital gain on sale of building. What you should do?
Close your eyes.
Nothing need to be done because there is no relaxation given. They didn't tell you to reduce it. Right? Provision for income tax. Badbeke, entire amount has to be added back. So look at the way they presented the book profit computation. Net profit as per P&L account. Add back. Provision for Niranjanana. Net profit for loss of subsidy. Add back. Provision for doubtful debts. Normally it will be deduction in the value of an asset. Add back. Provision for income tax. Everything should be added back. Entire depreciation first you add. Then deduct 1,50,000 related revaluation. 360 minus 1,50,000, 2,10,000 will be minus somewhere.
Minus.
Share of income. Income from units of UTI. Okay. I will change the answer. This answer will change. Correction what will be. Okay. Now 1035 has been withdrawn for 2021 previous year. Okay. Depreciation I said 360 minus 1,50,000 has to be minus. Unabsorbed depreciation, it is presumed to be as per books of account. Important. What are the information they are given? If it is as per books of account, then book depreciation or business loss, whichever less as per books of account has to be reduced. This is called book profit. So once you know that, and this again will change by
15%.
The old law prakara 18.5, now it will become 15%. Then education, etc. remain same. Similarly, one more question. So what I should do at the quick category, provision for income tax. The MAT is almost come add back. If it is debited,
add back.
Dividend distribution tax, add.
Add.
Secure transaction tax.
No.
Ignore. General reserve.
Add.
Appropriation. All items add. Provision for deferred tax.
Add.
Because of the income tax part. Proposed dividend.
Add, sir.
Appropriation item. Why thinking? Beyond appropriation account for the LBM items. Proposed dividend. Dividend distribution tax. Transport to the appropriation item. Will you pay first dividend? Will you pay income tax to the government?
Income tax.
And then all these items should have come after that. You have debited, you have to add back. I told in the class, why are you sleeping? preference dividend, add. Provision for permanent diminution in the value of investment. Assets, asset related, add back. Provision for gratuity based on actual valuation, don't add back. Just ignore it. Depreciation debit to P&L account, total lakh. This includes total same adjustment. Add 22 minus 16. Agricultural income. Agricultural income, 4 lakh is added. So other than minus money, expenditure on earning the same is 1 lakh rupees. Debited, you should add back.
Credit.
Add back.
Excluded. It's excluded from whatever. This undergoes change now. 1038. He got change again. Capital gain earlier it was exempted. Now it is a taxable. This law taxable. Will change. Okay. So other than the end, you should not do anything. You should not. Are you listening? Fine. You know, but interesting point is, one interesting point is 1038 law earlier also matter is same. I repeat confusion. The answer change agala idakku yellow up bitu red up bada 1038 is removed now but nimma mat answer change agala because earlier also 1038 was matable like 1008 artha aita
yes sir
so answer will not change so transfer to special reserve
add
transfer from revaluation reserve andre credit agirutre you have to minus
minus
from special reserve
erdu ade sir transfer from money special reserve ku transfer from
okay fine so erdu from me ide then you have to minus it aste minus next Bradford loss and as per books of account the previous question they are not given this question they specifically said as per books of account so whichever is less on a total basis total market minus made 6 plus 4 plus 3 is to 13 or
5
whichever is less logically when there is no depreciation you should not claim this 3 it should be 10 or 5 10 or 5 if you do an individual visit 10 or 5 but if you want to take the advantage it is 13 or 5 whichever less answer ultimately 5 above whichever less is 5 only no
5
either it there nodkodi illala mistake madidilla the amount credited to profit and loss from special reserve then depreciation excluding revaluation from revaluation reserve minus made thank you 18.5% will change. I think this kind of changes you can do it, Alva.
Yes, sir.
Madakagila nimma thing mada jeevana. And also normal tax also if you want you can bring it to 25%. If the turnover is below 400 crores you can bring it to 30% is also there but you can bring it to 25%. Carry forward like that. Similar provisions. I have given a lot of questions. Right. Next, advance ruling and settlement commission. Saka, I think we'll stop here. One second. Before that. Urgent idea. One accrued income November 19th suggests the answer on Madakito. Madabada, one beautiful question of others. Vartoga chance early. Question number 3A. Beautiful question. Quick ka godi yaradru. So 115 TD says a charitable trust should not merge with an institution which is not of similarly registered trust under 12EE. If you do that, the differential amount of assets and liabilities, which is called accreted income, which is going to be taxed at a maximum marginal rate. What is maximum marginal rate? The highest rate applicable to an individual. As of now, it is 30% plus 37% plus 4%. So MMR, those who don't know, make a note of it. 30% the highest rate applicable plus 37% surcharge plus on the total it is 4%. Oji sir.
GBB Charitable Trust engaged in the activity of running a charitable hospital and medical college since 8 years has been merged with corporate hospital on 31st March 2019. The said corporate hospital is not eligible for registration under 12AA of the Act. The position of assets and liabilities of the charitable trust as on the date of merger.
So it gives a clue to you that they are not supposed to add. So they are what you call they are merged. They are merged. Unfortunately, Alva.
Yes.
Next.
Shares and securities held by trust acquired out of agricultural income exempt under section 10(1) of the Act.
21. This question everybody compulsorily solve. Compulsorily solve this question. Next, I'll read sir. Book value of the shares and securities given. Market value is given. Okay, market value which is required for the definition. Yeah, it's color. Ine bortala. Ah, okay. I think I'll suggest the answer by say. You're not alone. Agalala.
No sir, agala.
ನಿನ್ನೆ ಒಂದು ಏನೋ ಬೇರೆ ಟ್ರೈ ಮಾಡೋ ಬಂತಪ್ಪ ಅದು ಹೈಲೈಟ್ ಇಲ್ಲೂ ಇಲ್ಲ ಆಪ್ಷನ್ ಇಲ್ಲ ಸಿ ಎಸ್ ಇಟ್ಸ್ ಗಿವನ್ ಸೆಕ್ಯೂರಿಟಿ ಓಕೆ ಬುಕ್ ವ್ಯಾಲ್ಯೂ ಆಫ್ ದ ಲ್ಯಾಂಡ್ ಸೊ ಬುಕ್ ವ್ಯಾಲ್ಯೂ ಲ್ಯಾಂಡ್ ವ್ಯಾಲ್ಯೂ ಆಫ್ ಇಮ್ಮೂಬಲ್ ಪ್ರಾಪರ್ಟೀಸ್ ದೆನ್ ಸ್ಟಾಂಪ್ ಡ್ಯೂಟಿ ವ್ಯಾಲ್ಯೂ ಇಸ್ ಗಿವನ್ ಟ್ರಸ್ಟ್ ಹೋಲ್ಡ್ 40% ಆಫ್ ಇಕ್ವಿಟಿ ಶೇರ್ಸ್ ಇನ್ ಅನ್ಲಿಸ್ಟೆಡ್ ಕಂಪನಿ ಅಂಡ್ ಫಿನಾನ್ಷಿಯಲ್ ಇನ್ಸ್ಟಿಟ್ಯೂಷನ್ ದೆನ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಸೆಡ್ ಅನ್ಲಿಸ್ಟೆಡ್ ಕಂಪನಿ ಆಸ್ ಆನ್ ದ ಡೇಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಮರ್ಜರ್ ದಿಸ್ ಇನ್ಫಾರ್ಮೇಶನ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಗಿವನ್ ಸೊ ಟೇಕ್ ಆಲ್ ದ ಇನ್ಫಾರ್ಮೇಶನ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಲಯಬಿಲಿಟೀಸ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿಸ್ ಎಂಟಿಟಿ ಓಕೆ ಸಪ್ನ ಬಿಡ್ಬಿಡಿ ಸಪ್ನ ಇದು ಸಪ್ನ ಯಾರೋ 91 ಸೆಕ್ಷನ್ 91 ಇರುತ್ತೆ ನೋಡಿ ಸಪ್ನ ಇಸ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಅಬೌಟ್ ಸೆಕ್ಷನ್ 91 ವಾಟ್ ಇಸ್ 91 ರಿಲೀಫ್ ರಿಲೀಫ್ ಕಂಪ್ಲೀಟ್ ಮಾಡೋದು ದೇ ಡು ನಾಟ್ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಅಗ್ರಿಮೆಂಟ್ ಅಂಡ್ 90 ಅಂತ ಕಾಣಿಸ್ತಾ ಇದೆ ಪ್ರಿಂಟ್ ಆಗಿದ್ದು ಇದು ಒಂದು 6 ಮಾರ್ಕ್ ಕ್ವಶನ್ ಕಂಪಲ್ಸರಿ ಆಲ್ಮೋಸ್ಟ್ ಎವ್ರಿ ಎಕ್ಸಾಮ್ ಓಕೆ ಆಸ್ ಪರ್ 115 TD ದ ಎಕ್ರೆಡ್ ಇನ್ಕಮ್ ಆಫ್ ಜಿಯೋಬಲ್ ಟ್ರಸ್ಟ್ ರಿಜಿಸ್ಟರ್ ಅಂಡರ್ ಸೆಕ್ಷನ್ 12A ವುಡ್ ಬಿ ಚಾರ್ಜೆಬಲ್ ಅಟ್ MMR 30% ಪ್ಲಸ್ ಆಗ ಸರ್ ಚಾರ್ಜ್ 12% ಇತ್ತು ಮ್ಯಾಕ್ಸಿಮಮ್ ಸೊ ನಾವು ಯು ಶುಡ್ ಮೀನ್ ಇದು ಚೇಂಜ್ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ ಚೇಂಜ್ ಮಾಡೋಕೆ ನನ್ನ ಕಲರ್ ಐ ಕೆನಾಟ್ ಚೇಂಜ್ ಬಟ್ ರಿಮೆಂಬರ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಬರ್ಕೊಳ್ಳಿ MMR 30% ಪ್ಲಸ್ 37% ಪ್ಲಸ್ 4% ಹೌ ಟು ಕಂಪ್ಯೂಟ್ ಎಷ್ಟು ಬರುತ್ತಮ್ಮ 42.74% ಓಕೆ ಸೊ ಹೌ ಡು ಯು ಕಂಪ್ಯೂಟ್ ಎಕ್ರೆಡ್ ಇನ್ಕಮ್ ಎಕ್ರೆಡ್ ಇನ್ಕಮ್ ಇಸ್ ಎಸೆಟ್ಸ್ ಮೈನಸ್ ಲಯಬಿಲಿಟಿ ನೆಟ್ವರ್ಕ್ ತರಣೆ ಬಟ್ ಫಾರ್ ದ ಎಸೆಟ್ ಕಂಪ್ಯೂಟೇಷನ್ ದೇರ್ ಇಸ್ ಎ ಮೆಕ್ಯಾನಿಸಮ್ ಹಿಯರ್ ಆರ್ ಯು ಸ್ಲೀಪಿಂಗ್ ನಾಟ್ ಯೆಟ್ ಅಂತ ಅನ್ಕೋಣ ಸೊ ಎಗ್ರಿಗೇಟ್ ವರ್ಕಿಂಗ್ ನೋಟ್ ನಂಬರ್ ಒನ್ ಎಸೆಟ್ಸ್ ಎಗ್ರಿಗೇಟ್ ಫೇರ್ ಮಾರ್ಕೆಟ್ ವ್ಯಾಲ್ಯೂ ಎಸೆಟ್ಸ್ ಆನ್ ಎ ಸ್ಪೆಸಿಫೈಡ್ ಡೇಟ್ ಶೇರ್ಸ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಸೆಕ್ಯೂರಿಟಿ ಬ್ಯೂಟಿಫುಲ್ ಪಾಯಿಂಟ್ ಇದು ದೇ ಪರ್ಚೇಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಶೇರ್ಸ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಸೆಕ್ಯೂರಿಟೀಸ್ ವಿಚ್ ಆರ್ ಔಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಎಕ್ಸೆಂಪ್ಟೆಡ್ ಇನ್ಕಮ್ those assets should not be considered. So any asset purchased out of exempt income should not be considered. All other securities which are purchased, please go through the question in detail, okay? So you need to take the average price which is given in the question, 40 lakh. Land and building, you are not supposed to go by the normal understanding. They say take the fair market value or the, what do you call the stamp value of rupees 38 lakh or in the class, whichever is higher. So the fair market value 40 lakh or the stamp value, whichever is higher, you should take 40 lakh. This is a danger provision. And equity shares in unlisted company, they are given the market value of the immovable property, etc. How to value the same? How do you do the valuation of FR? Assets minus external liabilities. Are you listening? So that's 70 lakh rupees. So that unlisted shares, you have to consider only 40%. Okay. Why? Because they are holding only 40% in the trust. And the question is, Thorsla, or you recall that point what I read here. Ikkada chudu. So 40% they are going to acquire. So that means assets minus liabilities will be the net worth of the company into 40%. Please go through and do the question. So total assets comes to 108 lakh. Total liabilities, okay, normally based on the book value, okay, unless the market value is specifically given. So 108 minus 23 lakh. So this is going to be like slum sale model now. So asset value 108, liabilities value 23 lakh, accreted income is 85 lakh. That on that you have to pay, you are supposed to pay the maximum marginal rate of 42 point whatever your sister said. Understood? This question you have to compulsorily solve. Compulsorily solve. This is one question I wanted especially you to focus. Then this is also there somewhere down, I think, May 19. Okay. Give me. And then we also have some recent exam question paper. Question 3A of May 19. Compulsorily solve. It is about MAT. Because I felt that's slightly different compared to the other provisions. You know, I'll just touch it now. 3A, I think 2A. Just. Ah, yeah. I'm sorry, it is 2. Question number 2. Question number 2. 3A is in November 19. Question number 2. Normal provisions are same, but this also considers Ind AS. Special provision of this question is Ind AS. Can't say the devarige. So Ind AS only. So apart from the normal 15 plus 15 minus 14, you also need to consider any other income which is taken to the OCI, other comprehensive income, has to be added back. And whenever you're applying Ind AS for the first time, That is called transition provision. Whatever the transition amount, you have to add 1/5 over 5 years. This is an extra point need to be taken care. So I'll just go through the answer straight away. Normal provisions are similar to the what we did explained earlier. Net profit, add back depreciation, interest on payment of delayed payment of TDS. Any interest under income tax law should be add back. Then depreciation other than on revaluation, share of income of EOP, same point. Amount withdrawal from revaluation. We have done only two questions now. I'll note it's to repetition. Amount withdrawal from revaluation reserve, brought forward business loss or depreciation loss, whichever less as per books of account. Are you there? And one special point is if it's a sick company, if it goes for IBC, okay, insolvency and bankruptcy code, it is a whichever less allah, it could be aggregate. I think this question, this IBC company though. So 8 crores, 3 crore or 5 crore, whichever less allah. If it is IBC, you have to add aggregate of the same has to be considered. After doing the normal computation, then you have to go for the further subsection 2C, 2A, 2B, 2C. Remeasurement of the employee benefit plan. So the items which are not taken to P&L, reclassified, the items which are taken to OCI, they have given information will be available that you add. The term revaluation is unheard in income tax. You should never consider the same. Artakta idea should, if it's considered, just ignore it. And transition amount, I think it is given in the question. So transition amount, which is excluding some items which are related to capitalism. Capitalism should never be a part of it. It's a special point. 500 lakh minus 50 lakh. So this will be the transition amount into 150. It comes to 90 lakh. So I repeat, transition amount should never consider capitalism. Capitalism is never taxable under any law. So 500 lakh minus 50 lakh is equal to 450 lakh. 450 lakh into 1/5. Okay. So that a transition amount which is to be added back. That will be called book profit. Then other things you continue in the usual manner. Instead of 18.5%, what do we call?
15%.
Yeah. There are two special problems in the recent exam I thought you must go through before we conclude. So this is the second session. Okay. So of the revision, one or two points. Next revision session will be on Friday. Okay. The last revision session. There I'll be taking up the left out practical areas of advance ruling, settlement commission, etc. They are same. Then if by God's grace, if the time permits, I may just go through the entire theory ones. Entire theory ones. I have got it. We are updating the theory material that will also will go through. Then two more extra points you should attend if you're writing in May 21. March somewhere we'll be conducting examination session. Compulsory attended examination session for all the 8 subjects. Next, CA Institute last time has requested me to take a RTP session for the entire Bangalore branch. They have done it. On a beautiful session. This time also it is going to happen because my student only is the SIRC chairman. Not because of that. Otherwise also I am taking session for years, sir. CA Institute. That RTP session, when I am taking it in CA Institute, that also you go through because it will be more specific to the amendments. A beautiful session. You can do that. First point. Now two RMRs. How many of you are writing exam in January? Please give this reaction. Some reaction. You know reaction coding. Only one. Savita two. Then anybody else? Asha, Anaga, Janesh. Then Savita. Diara, who else? Diyata was. Okay, right. Diyatiras. Sorry. So, okay. Now you people, what should you do? Two RMRs. Now, whatever we discuss about the problem solving, except where I mentioned about the amendment, let's make it simple. Problem solving, read the entire problems as it is without reading the red color. Wherever I said there's an amendment, I made red color. You don't see, you just have to read the way it is. Did you understand? For January 21 cycle I'm talking about. I'm talking to my friends who are writing in January 21, first point. So those who are writing in January 21, whatever the discussion I did in the problems area, that is applicable to you as it is without red color. All the amendment what I discussed, they are not applicable to you. So first point, you should not have heard that. You heard now, you can't help it. But anyway, in the process, you would have learned the law. That's okay, no problem. So all those amendments which have the budget 2020 are not applicable to you. Well, can anybody confirm this previous year 1920 only? I have not seen it. Anybody, Asha? For January 21 cycle also, in my opinion, it should be same as November 20. Dia, you are sure about it? Dia says yes. Okay. So So we go by that. So in my common sense, okay, same as November 20, Andre, the previous year 1920 for you. Thank you very much, Madhya. So November 2019 budget is applicable, including there is a budget number 2, finance act number 2 budget, which has been taken care of material. So those who are writing in January 2021, for you, it is a November 20 exam, whatever is applicable, OTAT is put and same is applicable. However, don't expect the same question paper to be repeated. That will not happen, okay? But questions of November 20 go through. The reason why I'm telling this is, normally C Institute has the habit of having 4 sets of question paper, what I understand from the internal information. And for every exam, suddenly one question paper, if it gets leaked, if something goes wrong, so then they'll select, they cannot suddenly call one person and do what you call arrange the question paper. So November 20, they will prepare 4 question paper. One randomly they select and they give. The second one, okay, third one, whatever, they'll select in this exam. That's what I presume, okay? That means the question papers would have been prepared on the similar lines. So November 20, whatever exams happened, it's available. If it's not available, you can ask our office people. So like 1 or 2 question paper I have shown now, November 20 examination question paper. Are you listening? So January 21 people, please refer November 20 question papers. First point. CAPS, whatever the discussion happened yesterday, today and Friday, the problems area what I'm discussing, there are 3 areas I'm going to discuss. One is about the budget 2020 that is not applicable to you. So whatever you have learned, delete it. So maybe might not have much impact. Second point is all the problems what I solved, as it is applicable to you, only wherever I made red color, you don't make red color, read the law as it is. For example, Matt last year also, Matt, I think 15% was there in November 20 also. Alva, you are Shabajita. 1 second. I think it was 2019 budget.
Last year.
2019 budget. Anyway, I'll just confirm it. I'm 99.99%. Sure, but still, because I remember teaching this last budget only. The kind of amendments we had in 2020, now which year we are reading, what other, we don't know. Yeah, 18.5%. Substitute for 18.5%. Okay, provide that 15%, 15%. So this is by 9. That is applicable for, so only red color applicable to January 21 is MAT rate. MAT rate is 15% for you also. Are you clear about it? So January 21 as well as May 21, MAT rate is 15%. Okay. So every other amendment where I made it red color, please don't see, because that material has been prepared for November 20 examination. Understood, my dear friends? Understood? Fair enough. Next. The third point is that material, whatever we have done. So if you want, I can circulate it. Maybe I'll just give me 30 minutes time. I have to think and do it. Okay. So I can circulate. Maybe you can, those who are new to CAPS, send your WhatsApp number saying, hi, I want this, whatever. So we will share that. I'm not able to. 83102-49327 or 9886-83697. So you can send, asking for it. If soft copy, if I can share it, I'll share the soft copy. Okay, fine. So whatever applicable number 20, it is readily available. It can be shared. Fine. Number 2, theory material. Theory material also for the November 20, which is applicable for January 21, is available. That also can be shared. How to share? I'll just take a make it. In half an hour, I'll think and share it with you. Fine. Those who are writing in January 21, these are the extra things you have to take care. November 20, all the question paper you go through. Then whatever you discuss, practical, same minus red color what I did, except for MAT. MAT has to be 15% only for you also. Then problems area will circulate. You can practice all the sum. Beautiful comparison. That itself will cover around 60% of the marks straight away in the examination. Then we will be circulating that material shortly. Then Friday, the last session, I'll be covering up the balance portion of the problem area. And also, if time permits, and May 21 and onwards, people, whatever I discussed in the last 3 days, mutat is applicable. I don't think I have to make any other statement. So because initially I didn't know that January 21 people are, many people are there. So since they are there, I just made the sentence. Are you clear about it? Fine. And next batch of CA final classes are starting at CAPS on Sunday. that is on 10th January morning 7 o'clock it starts. Okay, so normal class timings, we are starting with the SFM from Monday 6:30 to 9:30 by Tarun Jagadish sir, one of the brilliant teacher for SFM. Join and enjoy. Okay, your new students, many of you may be thinking our fees is so low. It is basically to ensure that everybody can afford CA course. That's the only objective. If you are think that no, only by paying high fees actually I can get extra knowledge, you can pay 1 lakh, 40,000 rupees to CAPS, 60,000 to CAPS Foundation, which does a lot of charitable activity. I'm serious. So you can charitable activity, you will also be getting some great. So I'm trying to say the fees is low just to ensure that everybody gets the best education. So and once you join, you can join multiple times in CAPS normally with the same fees. So enjoy the education and share the information, because many people don't know about CAPS, even being in Bangalore. My request is share the information about CAPS, how you felt. Okay, I don't say anyone to force anyone to join CAPS, because once they join, they'll automatically say it is definitely better than any other institute, at least in South India. Okay, so enjoy education. Fine. Anything else you want to ask before we conclude?
Sir, there will be provisos in the law, but they would not have numbered the first proviso, second proviso. The exam only, should we just say proviso 2 or should we say first proviso?
If you remember that proviso number, nothing like it. If you don't remember, you can write as per proviso to section 48. First, second, third, fourth, fifth, seven. You know that all the seven provisos, right? No. Your citizen student, section, clause, subclause, ella gottidalva. Being citizen student, you should write. But if you have apprehension or confusion, or the fourth or fifth, then better don't take a risk. As per proviso to 48. So when you know seventh proviso to 48, write seventh proviso. Clear about it? Fine. You will not do the mark. You will technically not do it. Wherever there is, see, when you write seventh proviso, valuer will be happy. He will give you one mark. When you write a proviso to 48, valuer is still happy. He will give you the mark. Same one mark. Okay. But that happiness might give you extra mark in the next question. Next, oh, this girl has extra knowledge. Anta, he will give you little extra, what you call, mark. Right, Becker? I am sure this is a student in the bracket. Yeah, don't take a risk. Next, unless the paper violation comes to CAP sites only. Even then, we will not consider that. We will maintain independence. Next, continue. Elizabeth, anything else? Enjoy. Chennagaita?
Yes.
Yes, sir.
All of you enjoyed?
Yes, sir.
Oh, good, good, good. Thank you. So, again, so this is what I always say, 5 P's in life. Proper preparation prevents poor performance. See, I want to take care of each student in an independent way. Some of the students here, including Surabhi, they would have attended this revision class earlier also twice. But when they come here, it should not be boring alone. That's why I tried to do something different. Now I felt this is more effective, because so teach the amendment, then go to the what you call the practical problem, that you will be able to register that things in a better way. I felt it is more beneficial. So it was too difficult for me because of the office present, but still night I sat. Not a great thing. 12:30 varike color ella markku ready markku bande. Otherwise again searching for the figure section will be too difficult job. Really. So we'll wait for one more beautiful session on the Friday, and Friday you remind me Surabhi about the feedback for the regular batch. Okay, we'll do that. Thank you, including the YouTube viewer. Thank you one and all. God bless you. Keep reading, keep enjoying. Namaskar Ashaka. Ota ide. Okay.
Thank you,
thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you.